You took a look at me and I thought you were a bastard. Hey, don't expect to answer the phone. You're fucking guy and sad and alone. I choose my number, cause I've seen the light. You're out of touch, and I know that I'm right.
A city. with the missionary zeal of St. Vincent de Paul and Louis de Marillac. They have served the people of Ross City and Capiz unselfishly for half a century. This performance tonight would not be complete without their participation. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome the Daughters of Charity.
May we request everyone, please turn off your cellular phone, beeper, radio, and electronic device so that there will be no interference to our technical equipment. Thank you.
give the closing remarks. But my remark is, I do not like closing. Because at this moment, I am a piece of heaven. What with the love shown by the people here, this must be God's work. And we would like to acknowledge the people. I'm not very young, and I'm afraid to forget. We wish to thank everyone who has come to join us in our joy tonight. Our beloved Monsignor Boeing, fathers and sisters, and guests. Our dearest personnel, the ancillary services personnel. College, faculty, and staff. The general services personnel. The finance services personnel. Our very dear doctors, both consultants and residents, our nursing service personnel, and I must not forget the people who feed us, in the canteen services person. As I have already mentioned to you, this must be God's work. I don't really know how it happened, but because it is something good, the devil works out double time to destroy it, to obstruct its success. I was the first victim of Satan, the evil spirit. When the concept of this night's affair was introduced to us for the first time, it was about the middle or about the end of August, and to be performed in early October, I was skeptical. I did not say a word, but I thought within me, how can that be? With so little time, it was not possible. What will the doctors say? We have so many patients to take care of. We have no time. How about the hospital personnel? We go on duty. When shall we attend to the affairs of this celebration? And the college, faculty, and staff, what we have classes? When shall we attend the practices? And everyone must have been thinking that way. I thought that was the evil spirit whispering to my ears. But lo and behold, you are witness tonight to what happened. After a short while, could you imagine how